Hi all, this is Dr. Mamta Java. In front of me, you can see certain bottles. What are these bottles? These bottles contain the antimicrobial discs. Alright, these discs we use for the disc diffusion method, which is a type of antibiotic sensitivity testing method, that is AST. Alright, so these discs are available in the market under the name of several manufacturers. For instance, I am holding one bottle manufactured by Hymedia. Now, as you can see nicely labeled on this bottle, this disc is carrying the circular discs, as you can see, 6 millimeter filter paper discs these are, and each has been impregnated with a specific antibiotic. For instance, in this case, we are seeing cefaparazone sulbactam combination. Alright, CFS is the short form, and CFS is engraved like this on the discs, and the quantity of cefaparazone and sulbactam respectively are 75 micrograms and 30 micrograms. Alright, so once these discs are purchased, they have to be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius, but the working stock can be kept at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we are going to refrigerate these discs when we buy them. And it's very, very important that for the daily purpose of AST procedure by the disc diffusion test, you have to, get these discs out of the refrigerator at least 1 hour prior to carrying out the disc diffusion method. Okay. And this is the another bottle of another antibiotic disc, that is tetracycline, 30 microgram. TE is the short form. Every disc is going to be, engraved with the short form TE, as you can see over here, along with the number 30, which represents the quantity of the antibiotic. The expiry date also is mentioned on the bottle, and it's very, very important to ensure that you're not using the expired discs, otherwise your results are not going to be appropriate. Okay, so this is tetracycline, and then we have got cefaparazone discs. Then what else we have right now? We have got doxycycline hydrochloride. Okay, this is 30 microgram discs. And finally, we have got azithromycin. Okay, guys, so once we have decided, once we have come to the conclusion whether we are dealing with a gram-negative isolate or a gram-positive bacterium, then we can select out of all these discs which drugs are going to work against gram-positive organisms or gram-negative organisms. So accordingly, we are going to make our choice of the discs which we are going to use in the disc diffusion method. Of course, there are certain antibiotics which are going to work against both gram-positive and gram-negative as well.